appreciate you doing this work, Ms. Tina. And I promise you, we will be respectful of everything. And if any questions that I ask, if you feel like you don't want to answer them, you are more than willing to say, I don't want to answer.
Okay.
So the first question is, could you tell us a little bit about your experience of getting tested?
I was donating blood to the Red Cross.
Okay.
And then one of my tests came back. I couldn't donate no more. So I had to go get tested. One of my, you know, they kind of test you before you donate blood.
Right.
And so,
they call you to say,
yeah,
or did you find out right then and there?
They called me and told me.
Okay. And then you made an appointment with your healthcare provider?
Where did I go? Well, I don't remember where I went. Yeah, but then I had to make a care with my healthcare provider. I think I went to some place they told me, the Red Cross told me to come down there.
Okay, just to get an additional test, just to see.
Yeah, to get an additional test. I think that's where I went first.
Okay. And how old were you at this time?
Maybe about 39.
Okay. Prior to your experience, how familiar were you with HIV?
I really wasn't familiar with it at all. You know, I had heard about it and everything, and I thought just gay people could get it.
Okay. You know, we definitely put that in the slide too, you know, that there's definitely, you know, a stigma about that. That's what we think.
Mm-hmm.
And with your experience, since everything has happened, have you figured out where you got it from?
I'm pretty sure where I got it from, but I'm not sure because I tried to contact the person and they never did say anything back or anything, so.
Okay. I am a healthcare provider as well. I'm a nurse practitioner. And with us, I kind of work with the health department, but not too much. I've only had to fill a few patients, their status. And they did like the tracing. You know, you had to fill them. You had been like in the health department contact them. Did they try and do that?
Yes.
Okay. And do you feel like you have a family support, or did you tell your family, or you just trying to keep it to yourself?
I have a lot of, my family supports me a lot. They understand. They don't bother me. Well, yeah, they support me, so they don't say anything about it.
Does your insurance pay for your treatment? Because, you know, we've talked about how sometimes part of the issue is people don't have access to the medication, right? But does your insurance?
Yeah, the medication is really, really, really expensive, and I have a really, really good insurance, so they do pay for mine.
Okay.
But some people may not be able to pay for it, but you know, it's some serums or something that maybe can give out some drugs to them.
Okay.
I think it's one in Macon.
Okay, yeah. I know I've sent a few patients over to the Hope Center.
Yeah, I think that's
just the whole thing. I actually saw last night that they actually have an injection now that you can take once a month.
Yeah, I've seen that
too. So I thought that was, you know, different. I said, they're getting more and more advanced with these treatments.
You too, I'm going to ask my doctor about that for a second.
You know, that could know a lot. And then, you know, you still get your numbers down to non-detectable, you know.
Yeah.
That's great.
You get the numbers out to non-detectable, they said you can take the shot. And then
right.
You don't have to take the pill every day. And with my other medication, with people have other medication like blood pressure medication and stuff like that, it gets to be hard to be taking pills all the time. Okay, you can go get tested like at any health department and like through donating blood and your regular physician.
Okay. And, you know, we didn't even think about the when you give blood. And I know that they do test it every time, but I think that's not something you put on the slide. But that is something I want to go back and add, for sure.
Okay.
So, Right, and then you weren't having any symptoms, you were just giving blood. And
I was giving blood. Yeah.
And then, right, so that's when you were 39. Since that time, have you been in a relationship where you felt comfortable to tell your partner?
No.
Okay. No. Okay. Is it just because you're scared to put yourself out there, or you just don't want to talk about it
with them yet? I don't want to talk about it with anybody yet, because a lot of people here in town, they know everybody.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody know everybody, and a lot of people still aren't educated on it.
Right.
How to get it, and they think it's, you know, really contagious and all of this stuff. But so they can easily get it if they touch you or something like that. And where I work at right now, it's the people there are just not conducive to coming over to agreeing with it, you know, changing their mind about anything right now.
Right.
They give a hard time. They give everybody a hard time. They hear anybody say something about it, they give them a hard time. And so, not to have any distractions at work, I just choose not to. And with my, I don't know nobody here. I wasn't born here, but I know a lot of people around here. So I try not to get involved with a lot of people over here.
Right. No, I'm saying.
So, because then, you know, you get involved in your feelings, you caught up in your feelings, and then you want to do something. And, no, you just don't want to do that. I just don't want to do that right now.
Yeah, I understand. Okay. And I am very grateful that you were willing to share with us today. I'm very thankful. You hit a lot of points that we're basically talking about, you know, the stigma, and the fact that you get down to undetectable that you can't, you know, change media. And when I saw it in the commercial yesterday, I said, they're finally, you know, putting it out to mainstream media, but it's like, you can't stand it for the longest, but nobody wants to listen.
Right, because once you get down to undetectable, like, I've been undetectable for about 10 or 15 years.
Wow.
But still, I think I can tell anybody who I have relationships with, so I'm not willing to do that, tell you yet, because I'm not that close to anybody yet, but hopefully one day I will. You know,
I
want to spend the rest of my life with my.
Right, you know,
so
I definitely understand.
Yeah, but it's a lot of couples out here that work it out, if you look at the commercials and stuff.
Right, and that's true, and some, you know, they're going to have kids as well,
right,
whether they adopt or they have their own child. And so, and the child comes out, you know,
don't want to tell.
Right.
So protect yourself.